Welcome to Section 12 of Introduction to Image Processing. This section is about applications of mathematical morphology in image processing. Mathematical morphology is the study of geometric structures like lines and shapes and relationships between those structures, which for digital images typically means relationships between each pixel and other nearby pixels. The principles of mathematical morphology lead to quite a diverse collection of operations. For example, this shows the morphological perimeter function used to draw a line around the white parts of an image. The morphological perimeter function works by putting a white pixel wherever a region of white pixels is adjacent to a region of black pixels. Here is another morphological operation called geodesic dilation, which takes a marker image and a second image that serves as a mask and returns a result that shows all of the white pixels from the mask that are connected to the white pixels in the marker image. Here is one more example which shows an operation called a top hat transform that removes large features and broad variations in shading from an image and gives a result that emphasizes the fine details in the image. What all of these operations have in common is that they all work by considering simple relationships between neighboring pixels. One of the simpler morphological operations is the maximum filter, which is implemented in a function called maxFilter and which is used here to remove the black noise pixels from an image. The maximum filter works by replacing each pixel with the lightest nearby pixel. Since the pixel value for a black pixel is zero, this has the effect of replacing all of the black pixels. For grayscale images, the maximum filter is a special case of a basic morphological operation called dilation. If the noise pixels had been white rather than black, then dilation, or the maximum filter, would actually make the white areas bigger. For that situation, there is a function called minFilter, which replaces each pixel with the darkest neighboring pixel, which has the effect here of replacing all of the white pixels. The minimum filter is a special case of a second basic morphological operation called erosion. The second argument in these functions specifies the size of the neighborhood, and in the erosion and dilation functions, the second argument can more generally be a matrix that specifies the exact shape of the neighborhood. For example, dilation with a second argument of 1 is equivalent to dilation where the second argument is a 3x3 matrix of 1s. This matrix indicates that the neighborhood extends one pixel in all directions from the pixel in the center. In the vocabulary of mathematical morphology, that matrix is called the structuring element, and the pixel in the center is called the origin. More generally, the structuring element is a matrix of 1s and 0s where the 1s indicate pixels that are to be included as part of the neighborhood of the pixel in the center. The structuring element can be any matrix of 1s and 0s. For example, this shows the effect of a structuring element with 1s on a diagonal. Asymmetric structuring elements like this are sometimes useful to achieve special effects or in other special situations, but usually the structuring element is either a matrix of 1s called a box matrix or a matrix called a disk matrix where the 1s are arranged roughly in a disk around the center. These examples show the effect of dilation with a box matrix and dilation with a disk matrix. Dilation is called dilation because it tends to enlarge or dilate the white parts of an image. For example, dilation applied to this image not only removes the black noise pixels, but also makes the white letters in the image larger and thicker. To restore those letters to their original size, and actually for a variety of other purposes, it is common to follow dilation with erosion, which in this example has the effect of removing the noise without changing the sizes of the shapes in the image. Dilation followed by erosion is called closing, and is done here by a function called closing. Similarly, erosion is called erosion because it tends to erode the lighter parts of an image. For example, erosion applied to this image removes the white noise pixels, but also erodes the lighter parts of the image. The lighter part of this image is the background, so erosion erodes the background, which here has the effect of making the black letters bigger. The letters can be restored to their original size using dilation, which removes the noise without changing the sizes of the letters. This combination of operations is called opening, which is simply erosion followed by dilation. The basic operations of erosion and dilation, and opening and closing, can be combined in a variety of ways to achieve useful effects. For example, since erosion makes the white areas in this image smaller, subtracting the erosion from the original image shows the pixels that were removed by erosion. The result is the so-called inner border of the image. This is the operation that is done by the morphological perimeter function. It is also possible to construct the so-called outer border by subtracting the image from the dilation of the image. This shows the outer border, which gives pixels that were added by dilation. Detection of borders, or detection of edges in general, is important in a variety of applications, and in particular came up in the section on segmentation, where edge detection was done using gradients. For example, this shows the gradient filter function used to emphasize the edges in an image, such as might be done in preparation for segmentation. Much the same effect can be achieved by subtracting the erosion of an image from the original image. This operation of subtracting the erosion of an image from the image is sometimes called the morphological gradient, which can be used in much the same way as the gradient filter. Another operation that came up in earlier sections is blurring or smoothing of an image, which is often done either for noise reduction or to suppress fine details in an image so as to emphasize features on a larger scale. This shows smoothing done using the Gaussian filter function, which came up in an earlier section. A similar effect can be achieved using a combination of opening and closing. This shows smoothing done using opening followed by closing. This input uses a disk matrix as the structuring element. Smoothing is often done prior to edge detection when the goal is to emphasize edges of larger scale features in the image. This shows edges detected using the gradient filter function, which uses Gaussian smoothing followed by a gradient magnitude filter. And this shows a corresponding result using morphological operations. The image is first converted to grayscale, the smoothing is done using a combination of opening and closing, and edges are detected using the morphological gradient, which means subtracting the erosion of the smoothed image from itself. The scale that is emphasized by this method can be adjusted by adjusting the size of the structuring element. Here is a manipulate input that includes a control for adjusting the size of the structuring element, which is again a disk matrix. Instead of subtracting erosion from the original image, subtracting the opening of an image from the original image gives an operation called a top hat filter that is useful for removing the background or for removing other large shapes in an image. For example, here is an image with light lettering on a dark background and where the background shows different shades of gray. The opening operation with a sufficiently large structuring element will remove the foreground and leave only the background. Here is a manipulate with a control for adjusting the size of the structuring element. For this image, a structuring element with radius larger than about 12 is sufficient to remove the foreground. The background can then be removed by subtracting the result of opening from the original image, which gives the lettering on a uniform background. The operation of subtracting the opening of an image from the original image is the top hat transform, which can be done using the top hat transform function. There are several morphological operations that involve repeated application of some basic transformation. For example, this shows an operation called geodesic dilation, which works by repeatedly applying dilation to a marker image or to seed pixels, shown here as red dots, and applying a mask after each dilation so that the pixels added by dilation are constrained to fall within the regions that are identified in the mask. To see in more detail how that was done, consider this image of a circuit board with many paths through the circuit. This image has been binarized to get pixel values that are 0 or 1 so that the image can be used as a mask. Geodesic dilation starts with a marker image like this one. Each step in the process consists of applying dilation and masking to the result from the previous step. This shows the first step, which consists of applying dilation to the marker image and then multiplying by the mask image to select only the pixels that are included in the mask. This shows the result after 6 more steps of dilation and masking. The geodesic dilation function effectively continues this process of dilation and masking until the image no longer changes, which in this example has the effect of tracing out complete paths through the circuit. Dilation followed by masking is called conditional dilation, so geodesic dilation is essentially a series of conditional dilations. A conceptually related operation is hysteresis thresholding, or double thresholding, which binarizes an image in a way that gives preference to connected pixels by using a different threshold for pixels that are connected to pixels that meet an initial threshold. As an example, consider binarizing this image of an insect wing to isolate the veins in the wing. The veins are edges in this image, so it is reasonable to begin by applying a gradient filter to emphasize the edges. Binarizing that image using a single threshold is only partially successful, since a threshold that is low enough to include the wing veins also includes pixels that are not within the veins, and a threshold that is high enough to include only pixels from the veins gives a result with large gaps along the veins. This problem can be addressed by constructing a mask image using a threshold that is low enough to include connected pixels along the wing veins, constructing a marker image using a threshold that is high enough to include only pixels that fall on the wing vanes, and then applying geodesic dilation using those mask and marker images. The result is an image showing pixels with values above the higher threshold, or that are connected to pixels with values that are above the higher threshold. This is effectively what is done by the morphological binarize function. That's the end of the examples from this section. To summarize, here is some of the vocabulary from this section. This section included examples of image processing operations that work by considering relationships between pixels and the connectedness of pixels. You can find more information about these and a number of other morphological operations in the section on mathematical morphology in the Wolfram documentation.